I've been trying to figure out what it means to be human, flesh and bone, the spirit and the soul. If I cannot earn your love by trying to measure up, why do I think I'd lose it in the lose? Somehow you see through my heart, and you welcome me with open arms, just as I am. In the good and the bad, you still understand, and you never stop loving me, just as I am. With the heart of the Father and grace like no other, you never stop loving me, just as I am. You've been patient with my wondering, always knowing what I need. With a gentle hand, you show me where to go. No, there hasn't been a moment you were calling out to me. I heard your voice and now I'm coming home, just as I am. In the good and the bad, you still understand that you never stop loving me, just as I am. With the heart of the Father and grace like no other, oh, you never stop loving me, oh, just as I am. I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you for loving me. I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you for loving me. I just want to say thank you.
Good morning. Merry Christmas again. We're glad you've joined us for this very special service of lessons and carols. This is a tradition in the churches that I serve. Usually the Sunday after Christmas, we sing a lot of the carols and just enjoy sort of a closing out the season in a fun way, sort of informal way. We're not going to have a sermon. There's no communion. It's going to be... It's going to be, no sermon today. We're going to let the scriptures speak for themselves, and we're going to sing a lot, so hope that you're in good voice today. We thank you. You've joined us on Facebook. As you heard, there's no communion, so you don't have to prepare communion elements at home today, but we will do that starting again next week. Next Sunday will be the first Sunday of the new year, of course, and we will be doing a form of John Wesley's covenant renewal service, sort of a New Year's recommitment service, and we're going to install our leaders for 2022 next week, so I hope that you'll come and be a part of that service next week. On January 9th, which is two Sundays from now, we're receiving a group of new members. We have four for sure who are joining, maybe five. And if you are not yet a member and you'd like to become a member, it's a great time to join. Contact me. My contact information is available. Well, it's not on the bulletin. I don't know if it is on the bulletin this time. But contact me, call the church office, or give me a call. And we'd love to welcome you next on the 9th. If you're a leader or if you want to participate in our retreat on January 8th, which is a Saturday, for our planning for the future of our church, please sign up in the narthex. There's a clipboard there. This is for all leaders, of course, but also anybody in the church who'd like to be a part of that conversation. It'll be from 9 until 3, and we'll have lunch, and it'll be a wonderful day of planning and visioning for the future. You see, we want to thank everyone who made our holiday so beautiful and special this year in the church. All those who worked for decorating the church. It's always a big job, and they're going to be undecorating the church and packing things away, so we thank them, all those who are participating in that. We thank you for giving poinsettias. We have lots of poinsettias. Some were taken after Christmas Eve. If you have some that you haven't picked up, please take yours. And even if you didn't give poinsettias, but you have a neighbor or someone that you think would be meaningful to bring them a poinsettia from the church, please take them. I mean, they're not going to last much longer, so please take them with you. Otherwise, we'll just put them out here, and you can pick up one later if you want to plant one in your yard. We always have extras, so please make sure they go to good homes. There's a registration pad in the pew. It's helpful if you register your attendance and let us know you're here. Let us prepare our hearts for worship. Thank you. stand as we join together in our call to worship. Sing to the living God, sing a new song.
Sing to God, all the earth.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light.
On those who lived in
the land as dark as death, a light has dawned. For a child has been born to us,
a son given to us.
Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named
Wonderful
Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Let the heavens be glad, let the earth rejoice. Let the field exult, and everything in it.
Let the trees and the forest sing for joy.
For the living God is coming, coming to judge the earth,
to judge the world with righteousness,
and the peoples with truth. Let us lift up our voice together and singing Angels from the Realms of Glory.
Listen for God's word from the prophet Isaiah. A shoot shall come out from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, and the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide by what his ears hear. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall live with the lamb. The leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, the young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall pray over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put his hand in the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my body, my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. second lesson is from Micah chapter 5, verses 2 through 5. Listen for the word of God from the prophet Micah. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrah, you are the one of the little clans of Judah. From you shall come for me one who is to rule Israel, whose origin is from old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up unto the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel, and he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
For the record and for the ages, St. Matthew has recorded the lineage of our Lord. And so listen for the word of God from the Gospel of St. Matthew in chapter 2. An account of the genealogy of Jesus the Messiah, the son of David and the son of Abraham. Now Abraham was the father of Isaac, and Isaac the father of Jacob, and Jacob the father of Judah and his brothers, and Judah the father of Perez and Zerah by Tamar, and Perez the father of Hezron, and Hezron the father of Aram, Aram the father of Amminadab, and Amminadab the father of Nashon, and Nashon the father of Salmon, and Salmon the father of Boaz by Rahab, and Boaz the father of Obed by Ruth, and Obed the father of Jesse, and Jesse the father of King David. Bear with me now. And David was the father of Solomon, by the wife of Uriah, and Solomon the father of Rehoboam, and Rehoboam the father of Abijah, and Abijah the father of Ahab, and Asaph the father of Jehoshaphat, and Jehoshaphat the father of Joram, and Joram the father of Uzziah, and Uzziah the father of Jotham, and Jotham the father of Ahaz, and Ahaz the father of Hezekiah, and Hezekiah the father of Manasseh, and Manasseh the father of Amos, and Amos the father of Josiah, and Josiah the father of Jechonas and his brothers. And this was at the time of the deportation to Babylon. And after the deportation to Babylon, Jeconiah was the father of Salathiel, and Salathiel the father of Zerubbabel, and Zerubbabel the father of Abiud, and Abiud the father of Eliakim, and Eliakim the father of Azor, and Azor the father of Zadok, and Zadok the father of Akim, and Akim the father of Eliud, and Eliud the father of Eleazar, and Eleazar the father of Mathan, and Mathan the father of Jacob, and Jacob the father of Joseph, the husband of Mary, of whom Jesus was born, who is called the Messiah. So all the generations from Abraham to David are 14 generations, and from David to the deportation to Babylon are 14 generations. And from the deportation to Babylon to our Messiah, 14 generations. The word of God for the people of God.
Listen for God's word from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 1, verses 26 through 38. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God, and now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son, and this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Listen for the word of God from the Gospel of Matthew. Now the birth of Jesus the Messiah took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us." When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until she had borne a son, and he named him Jesus. Word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Jesus.
Listen for the word of God from the Gospel of Luke. In those days, a decree went out from the Emperor of Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth of Galilee to Judea, the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver this child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in the bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Listen to the word of God from the Gospel of Luke. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all of the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was the angel, with the angel, there was a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace among those whom he favors." When the angel left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. And the word, this is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Listen for the word of God from the Gospel of St. Matthew. In chapter 2, he writes, "In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, 'Where is the child who has been born of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage.' When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, 'In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, and you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are by no means least among the rulers of Judea. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod secretly called the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, 'Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found them, bring me word that I may go and pay homage to him myself.' When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was born. When they saw the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. And then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of frankincense, gold, and myrrh. But having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another way." The word of God for the people of God.
Just as the wise men traveled to the Christ child and presented him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, symbols of their devotion, so now we present to God our tithes and offerings.
Thank you.
Listen for the word of God from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 2, verses 13 through 23. Now after they had left, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Get up, take the child and his mother, and flee to Egypt, and remain there until I tell you. For Herod is about to search for the child to destroy him." Then Joseph got up, took the child and his mother by night, and went to Egypt, and remained there until the death of Herod. This was to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet, "Out of Egypt I have called my son." When Herod saw that he had been tricked by the wise men, he was infuriated, and he sent and killed all the children in and around Bethlehem who were 2 years old or under, according to the time that he had learned from the wise men. Then was fulfilled what had been spoken through the prophet Jeremiah. A voice was heard in Ramah, wailing and loud lamentation, Rachel weeping for her children. She refused to be consoled because they are no more. When Herod died, an angel of the Lord suddenly appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt and said, "Get up, take the child and his mother, and go to the land of Israel, for those who were seeking the child's life are dead." Then Joseph got up, took the child and his mother, and went to the land of Israel. But when he had heard that Archelaus was ruling over Judea in place of his father Herod, he was afraid to go there. And after being warned in a dream, he went away to the district of Galilee. There he made his home in a town called Nazareth, so that what had been spoken through the prophets might be fulfilled. He will be called a Nazarene. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Would you join me in prayer? When children are abused,
we share our anger.
When children are in pain,
we share our distress.
When children are murdered,
we share our horror.
When children die,
we share our strength.
God, who welcomes and cherishes children, we bring you our prayers. We pray for children living and dying in places of fear and violence, for children dying of hunger and disease. God of mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for children who have been abducted from their homes, for children who are pawns in political games. God, in your mercy, we pray for children who are tortured and abused, for children whose lives are short and full of pain. God, in your mercy, we pray for parents who have to watch their children die, for parents who are unable to keep their children safe. God, in your mercy, we pray for children and parents and guardians in our midst, for all who love them and support them. God, in your mercy. God of earth and heaven, in times of pain and in times of plenty, we seek your blessing. Lay your hands on us in love and give good gifts to your children. In Jesus' name and in the love of the Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen.
Some children see him lily white, the baby Jesus born this night. Some children see him lily white, with tresses soft and fair. Some children see him bronzed and brown, the Lord of heaven to earth come down. Some children he see him bronzed and brown, with dark and heavy hair. Some children see him almond-eyed, this Savior whom we kneel beside. Some children see him almond-eyed, with skin of yellow hue. Some children see him dark as they, sweet Mary's son to whom we pray. Some children see him dark as they, and ah, they love him too. Children in each different place will see the baby Jesus' face, like theirs but bright with heavenly grace and filled with holy light. endless offering. Come worship now the infant King. 'Tis love that's born tonight.
Listen for the word of God from the Gospel of John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. The Word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Please stand.
Thought it was beautiful and a fitting way to close out 2021 as we look to 2022. As the year wraps up and draws to a close, may you let go of any lies you picked up along the way. May you shake off any offenses that are still hanging on. May you instead wrap yourself up in the complete love and acceptance of Christ. May you forgive yourself and others. May you believe that God's promises are more powerful than your blunders. May you embrace God's redemptive plan for your life with hope and expectancy. May God heal your soul and make you whole. May he restore your health and renew your relationships. And may he give you a fresh vision and powerful faith for the days ahead. Walk forward with faith and expectancy. Jesus is with you every step of the way.